Hi everyone, my name is Francesco Fantechi and today I want to be talking about my experience with Goldman Sachs and drive you through one day as a financial analyst with the firm. Basically, my day starts at around 6:30 a.m. Mountain Time and I have to be in the office at 7:30 a.m. Mountain Time, which is 9:30 a.m. Eastern time, which is exactly the moment when the markets open for the day. It's very important to be in office when the markets open because there are a lot of different tasks and duties that we have on a daily basis, and therefore we need to make sure that we perform them as soon as we get to the office. Basically, my role with the company is a financial operation security settlement analyst, which means that basically my job is to connect with other brokers, with other financial institutions, with other mutual funds, hedge funds, and so on, in order to make sure that the trades that were done and executed by the front office in New York are matched and settled exactly in the right weight and with the right analytical parameters. In particular, what we mainly do deal with are securities and cash. So we have to match and recognize the trades that are executed and make sure that these parameters are settled correctly. So for example, let's make an example a little bit complicated in order to make sure that we understand what a financial operational security settlement analyst does in Goldman Sachs. So let's imagine that JP Morgan on the 1st of May has gone short 10,000 shares of Accenture, and it needs to contact Goldman Sachs in order to lend those securities and then sell them to the market. Okay, so what's happening now? So first of all, the trade is executed. Okay, so we lend 10,000 shares of Accenture to the JP Morgan. JP Morgan sell them to the market with many different kinds of orders that can be. So it can be, for example, the two most important kinds of orders are the market order, that is when the firm just sell, or the trader just sells all the shares at a certain market price, or a limit order in which the firm or the trader decides to set a certain price for the short sell of 10,000 shares of Accenture. Around 2 days later, 2 business days later, the trade is settled, okay, following standard procedures. But there can be a lot of different parameters that need to be checked and need to be controlled, okay? So for example, in this case, since it's a short sale, the mechanics is that Goldman Sachs delivers 10,000 shares of Accenture to JP Morgan. JP Morgan sends the cash, which is 10,000 shares multiplied the price of the security in that moment, and they basically put it in an escrow, which serves as collateral for the trade, because of course Goldman Sachs is not selling these shares, but it's just lending 10,000 shares to JP Morgan for them to sell to the market. But of course there should be a collateral, which is the market value of those shares. And Goldman Sachs needs to make sure that this collateral is received and put in an escrow up until the trade is basically closed, which means that the position of JP Morgan is reverted from short to buy, okay? And in that case, that money that is an escrow will be freed up and will go back to JP Morgan, which will settle accordingly the trade with all the different counterparties that it has dealt with when short selling the 10,000 shares. Moreover, and this is also very important to understand, there is a certain interest rate on the fact that JP Morgan is basically borrowing some securities. So what happens when you short sell a certain security? What happens is that you pay a certain interest rate. In this case, JP Morgan pays a certain interest rate to Goldman Sachs because of the fact that it's because of the fact that they are lending, they are borrowing securities, and therefore they are paying a certain amount of cash in addition to the collateral that they put in this escrow temporarily. We have to notice that in this case the interest rate on the securities is paid directly to the company, and therefore it's wired. In the US in particular, we use the call wire when we mean a direct transfer of money, because it's an electronic transfer and therefore it's called a wire transfer, when we transfer directly this money from JP Morgan to Goldman Sachs. And therefore there are all these different parameters that need to be checked, need to be and dealt with the counterparty once the trade is executed. Once the different parameters of the trades are checked and accepted by both counterparties, and in specific financial language we say that the trade is matched, which means that is recognized by both counterparties, then we can definitely settle the trade. Of course, this was just an example, and there could be a lot of different situations that we need to deal with. This is a situation that it has a medium to high level of difficulty because of the fact that we have also to deal with an escrow and with interest rate exchange of money. Of course, there can be more difficult kind of trades, but there can also be easier ones, such as, for example, a normal buy of shares in which we simply, let's imagine that the same JP Morgan buys $10,000 of Accenture, we simply deliver these shares to JP Morgan, which in turn delivers cash. But, for example, there can be also many different securities, no, that can be exchanged, right? So what broker dealers do is they calculate all the different securities that they have to exchange on a daily basis, and then they just swipe the total amount of money. So you make one single deal of money for every single day on the basis of all the securities and the cash that need to be exchanged. Then there are also balance orders, which are orders that are specifically done at the end and at the beginning of the day, and are a little bit more complex to deal with. And this is the reason why I'm not going to cover them into this video, because the mechanics of the exchange of cash, securities, interest rate, and so on, it can be very complex, because generally these are situations in which you basically match your trade with a lot of different brokers, and therefore there are inter-brokers platforms and softwares that need to be addressed, and the mechanics are a little bit complex, and therefore I'm not going to cover them directly today. Another important thing to understand is that sometimes there is not a general agreement onto the trade. So this means that as Goldman Sachs, we recognize a certain analytical parameters of exchange of different securities and cash, but at the same time the other counterparty does not recognize those analytical parameters. This is called a break, and it's generally speaking a discrepancy between Goldman Sachs analytical parameters of the trade and the specific counterparties of the trade. And in this case, there are some, of course, evidence to, that need to be addressed. There are some, you know, information that need to be recovered in order to be able to match the trade and therefore settle it generally for securities and cash. Generally speaking, we can say that the majority of breaks are caused by human errors. So, for example, if out of, I don't know, 300 trades for a day, I accept instead of reject a certain trade, a certain parameter, then of course there's going to be a break because, for example, I accept features that are not accepted by the counterparty or I refuse features that instead needed to be accepted. But it's something that happens very normally, and there are specific departments of the business unit that deal with breaks and disagreement between the between Goldman Sachs and the counterparty. Another important thing that it's that I engage in my Goldman Sachs experience is inventory management. Okay, so one of the most important activities that we need to do in the morning is making sure that the inventory is released or held for certain kind of security. So, for example, we can decide that on certain days, because some securities need to be delivered to the counterparty, we have to release them, which means that we have to basically make sure that they can be easily transferred throughout the day. Instead, if, for example, in the night before on a certain trade there was a disagreement and therefore a break between our company and the counterparty, then what is going to happen? It's going to happen the fact that we have to hold those securities. So even if the counterparty would like us to release, we have to hold them in order to have different information. And then, of course, there are different inventories within the firm, and we have to make sure that any of those is always up to date with the amount of securities and cash that on average is needed throughout the day for the trades that you know we can forecast to be engaged in regardless with a certain margin of safety, of course, because for example, if we expect that on average we release 10,000 shares of Accenture every single day, we will have of course a very high margin of safety. If more than the amount of shares that need to be released on average is higher than usual, and therefore we will make sure that we always have a margin of safety on the securities that are exchanged between the back offices of our of Goldman Sachs and the other firm, okay, the other broker dealer. Generally speaking, to go into a little bit more details of how my life looks like, I generally we work around 12 hours per day. 12 hours per day means around 60 hours per week, so the amount of work that we perform on a daily basis is very very high. Of course, it's an investment bank with a lot of different duties and tasks and processes to be performed on a daily basis, and therefore the day is pretty long, even if the job is very interesting. I want to make sure that as a financial operational analyst, I mostly deal with processes and standard procedures. Some of them are mapped in the website of the company, some of them are not mapped in the website of the company. So one of the most important things that we have to do is also like trying to understand what enhancements and improvements can be made to the processes that we are responsible for. So let's imagine there is a certain process that involves a certain quantity of steps. We have to understand whether it's possible to enhance and improve the process in a way that it has less bottlenecks and it can run more smoothly than it is previously it was previously conceived, right? So we have to also give our opinion on the processes that can be addressed, enhanced, and so on. Generally speaking, I would really recommend this kind of work, of job, if you are interested in the financial markets. Of course, as I said, it's an operational financial role, and it's not directly linked with the evaluation of companies, even if this is probably what I am most interested and keen on, in addition to understand the mechanics of trading, which is something that is done, and of course the valuations of the trades, which is something that is done in the front office. Generally speaking, as I said, you need to have in another video, you really need to have a very strong work ethic in order to work for Goldman Sachs, because there are a lot of hours that need to be put in, and therefore you are going to need to really work very strong. Even if this is something that has never worried or bothered me, because I am a very keen and hard worker, and generally speaking, the more I work, the happier I am in a company, because I can understand things faster, try to give my opinion on the processes and things, tasks and duties that are done. So generally speaking, I would really advise such an experience. About the company, of course, we know that Goldman Sachs is one of the most important investment banks in the world, and it's very, very strong as a company. People are very have a very good work ethic, they work very well, even if the Salt Lake City office is still in reorganization, and therefore a lot of processes and procedures that are there are still in need to be reorganized, and of course the workflow needs to be addressed, and generally speaking built in slightly a better way, but this is just the way it is, because of course there is a reorganization going on into the company, and therefore a lot of these processes and procedures that there are will be addressed, changed, modified, and enhanced and improved in the months to come. I guess that was all for today. If you like the video, please smash the thumb up and leave a comment here stating what you think about this specific job and this specific experience with Goldman Sachs. Moreover, if you are interested in learning about finance, investing, money online, and all these different things, subscribe to the YouTube channel here. A lot of new content is going to come up very soon, so smash the thumb up again, subscribe, comment. I'm looking forward to come tomorrow with a new video. Thank you all for the attention. Enjoy the rest of the weekend and the beginning of your next week. Thanks a lot again. Have a great rest of your night.